What I always felt is that if I'm me and I make this kind of music, it's wrong if I should try to fashion my songs or my music to suit a market. And I think that kind of thing was happening in the 70s. It was like, everybody, you've got to do this kind of song, otherwise we can't get it on the radio. That's when I decided, oh, I'm getting out of here. So now that's what it is. It's like somebody once said, take me as I am or let me go.
And you yourself made lots
of them. Oh, I knew the Rolling Stones when they were all Brill Cream.
You worked with Madonna on Shanghai Surprise.
I tried to.
That sort of answers my question. What was that like, working with her, or trying to?
It was, you know the truth, it was a pain in the ass. Because we were doing a comedy movie, she hasn't got a sense of humor. I see like pop stars being teenagers and that, and it's sort of funny when you're getting on like this. I know there's people far older than me doing it, but it's sort of, it's a funny business. I don't really see myself as any of those things. It's all part of me. Just like being a gardener on occasion, you know, so I'm a gardener too, but I'm not really a gardener either, you know. I play a bit of guitar, write a few tunes, make a few movies, but none of that's really me. The real me is something else.
実はこのレコードは特にアメリカのラジオ局では何を今さらジョージ・ハリソンがということで敬遠されたらしいんですけども、ジョージ・ハリソンのことを全然知らないティーンエイジャーのファンたちの支持を得まして、この曲は2ヶ月かかって全米でナンバーワンになっております。
彼に今回のアルバム、そして The Beatles 時代のことについてインタビューしています。
I'm gonna make a record like something like 20 years ago, just like a rock and roll band making a record, except the modern technology, it's going to sound like now, like it's just being made now. But I avoided all those sort of drum machines and all those kind of things, MIDI this and that and the other, and all these emulator little phony trumpets and stuff. We had real saxes and real guitars, real pianos, real drums, real people playing real songs. Every day was like living 10 years, you know, in concentrated experiences. Like we met everybody in the world and, you know, we didn't have a moment's peace. And, you know, it was all this sort of stuff. Everybody dreams of being famous and rich and famous. Once you get rich and famous and you think, this isn't it, there's still something missing now. And it doesn't matter how much money or property or whatever you've got. Unless you're happy in your heart. I always really enjoyed in our early days, before we got too famous, we used to play clubs and that kind of stuff all the time, you know? And it was fun, but it's good because you get to play and you get to get quite good on your instrument, but then we got famous and it spoiled all that because we'd just go round the world singing like the same 10 dopey tunes. We'll see. I won't say that I'm not going to do any concerts, but, you know, I'm not going on a Spinal Tap tour. It was, do you want the truth? It was a pain in the ass.
Why?
Because we were doing a comedy movie. She hasn't got a sense of humor. And her husband, Sean, who's a really nice, intelligent fella, and I had a laugh with him at times, but, you know, he sort of gets all uptight and, you know, cause all the trouble. And it was like the producers, you know, where he says, I picked the wrong cast, the wrong actors, the wrong director. You know, where did I go right? I mean, unless we do something about it, every Beatles song that's ever been done is going to end up advertising, you know, brassiers and pork pies and, you know, motor cars or whatever. And I think the Beatles themselves, seen as we created the music and it's our records, I think we should be the ones to choose whether it's, you know, if, whether we want it. It's nothing personal against Nike particularly, but you can see the problem. If we don't do something about it, it's going to go on forever. Every tune we ever had is going to become some sort of advert.
George Harrison keeps the number one position in the country for the second consecutive week with Got My Mind Set On You.
I got my mind set on you. I got my mind set on you.
今週のナンバーワンは見事2週連続のトップをキープしたジョージ・ハリソン Got My Mind Set On You でした。すでにこのナンバーは全米シングルチャートでナンバーワンを獲得していますが、実にジョージ・ハリソンにとっては24年前 The Beatles がリリースした I Wanna Hold Your Hand 以来の大記録になります。また彼の次のビデオクリップなんですが When We Was Fab に決定していまして、ビデオクリップの監督は巨匠ゴドレ